This is Mission Control Houston. Welcome to today's ISS update for Wednesday, November 2nd, 2011. You're looking at a live view inside the International Space Station flight control room here at the Johnson Space Center. This is the Orbit 2 team. It is being led today by Flight Director Dina Cantella. There are two Capcoms today. On the far left is veteran astronaut Shannon Lucid. And sitting beside her is Jeremy Hanton, also serving as today's Capcom and doing some training today. Of course, the big news of today is the arrival of the Progress 45 cargo craft to the International Space Station. That cargo craft successfully rendezvoused and docked with the International Space Station today at 6:41 a.m. Central Time. They've been working on getting the hatches open in between the International Space Station and that cargo craft. They will be doing an air sampling coming up here shortly just to make sure that the air inside is acceptable. And then they will begin the process of unloading that Progress over the next several days and weeks. Taking out all of its 2.8 tons of supplies. That Progress brought up 1,653 pounds of propellant, 110 pounds of oxygen, 926 pounds of water, and 3,108 pounds of dry cargo. It will be attached to the station for the next several months, and then ultimately it will be packed full of trash and deorbited in the Earth's atmosphere, just like all the Progresses before it. The crew also working on a variety of experiments today, including an eye exam for Expedition 29 Commander Mike Fossum, as well as Satoshi Furukawa, one of the flight engineers on board. Sergei Volkov also busy in the Russian segment with his Progress work. The crew is also going to be swapping out the lens on what is known as the Earth Cam. We talked about that earlier this week. This is a student-driven payload that's on board the International Space Station. There is a camera mounted in the window, pointed down at the planet below, and through a series of commands sent through the internet, the students can actually program that camera to take different pictures of different man-made and natural occurring phenomena down on the planet, and then the students use those pictures in their classroom study. So Mike Fossum will be working with that today. The crew also doing some routine housekeeping on board the station today. They're going to be cleaning out some of the ventilation that's there inside PMA-1. PMA-1 is actually the joint in between the Russian and U.S. segments. It binds the Zarya module, which was the first piece of the International Space Station launched back in 1998, with the Unity node, which was the first piece of the U.S. segment that was launched just a few short weeks after Zarya. Periodically, the crew has to clean those ventilation connections there in those modules that make sure that the air gets stirred and is acceptable for the crew members to live in. The crew also has some crew Earth observations today, including Pakistan, St. Lucia. They'll also be flying over a volcano in Mexico. They'll also be passing over Wells Creek Impact Crater in Tennessee. And also an unusual chance for them to capture imagery of the Great Barrier Reef there off the coast of Australia. Typically, the crew is asleep during the daylight passes over Australia, but today they have a chance to actually gather some imagery of what will sure to be some spectacular photographs of that phenomena off the coast of Australia. Of course, for the latest information on the Expedition 29 crew to follow along as they get this Progress up and running, you can always log on to our website at www.nasa.gov.